record 570680. Counsel your appearance, please.
Clearly casting 11654, the plaintiff who's also present.
Thank you. Sir, your name?
David Hoff.
Representing yourself today?
Yes, sir.
All right. We're here today for calendar call. We have your trial set in a couple of weeks.
Actually next week. We were asking if
it is next week, yes.
Continued out because we're having trouble with the Nevada Parole Board giving us over some different documentation about why his parole was just revoked. They filed a motion to quash my subpoena, and it's being heard on April 17th. We've opposed that, and we're trying to get a hold of like the violation report and underlying documentation about why he was just sent back to prison, that kind of thing. I think it's critical for you to be able to read and understand his recent behavior and why he was revoked.
So you're requesting continuance?
Correct. We had filed an ex parte application because we weren't sure where he was. He was being transferred from Nevada to Idaho, so we didn't know where to send it to. We didn't have any addresses, so we filed it. It's like an ex parte app to apply to move the trial date. We're just trying to let you know that we were not ready. I figured you couldn't grant it that way, but we just wanted to warn everyone we're not ready.
Right.
This is why I need this additional time. I don't know that he has any opposition to that because he's not represented. And I've been, Jay Barrick has reached out to me a couple times that she's interested, but I don't know if there's a payment issue or something like that. That would probably behoove the defendant to have more time to try to get a hold of someone and pay someone to help him. I don't know if that's within the law.
What, so just so we're all on the same page, sir, counsel's orally requesting to continue this matter out. Are you opposed to a continuance?
Yes, Your Honor. I was just released March 25th, and I now live in Idaho, and I haven't had any time to acquire representation or get all the witnesses.
So you would like a continuance?
Yes,
okay.
Your Honor.
All right. Then maybe I asked the question backwards. How much time do we think we need?
Well, our hearing is on April 17th. I don't know that it will be sorted out that day, just having too many discovery disputes to mention.
No.
So maybe 2 or 3 months?
Sir, what do you think?
Yes, sir. Yes, Your Honor.
July 23rd, 1:30. At 11?
Yes.
Does that work?
Sorry, I'm not trying to. We weren't aware that he was going to be present today. There is a TBO in place that I don't think he's been served with. We were at a hearing recently, and it was continued for service reasons. I have a copy here. Is there any objection to it?
No, you can hand it to him, and we'll make that notation in open court that he received the application in open court today. Yeah, I didn't see the one. All right, then we'll set you for the 23rd at 1:30. You'll be on a stack, and your calendar call will be the, 16th?
Calendar call is July 9th.
9th at 11 a.m. And we'll get you those dates. We'll continue out. We'll have your pretrial memos be due on the 4th. I'm sorry, well, that's not going to work. It's a holiday. On the 5th of July.
May I ask questions?
Yes.
Am I allowed to have counsel appointed? I'm still under formal paupers until August.
We don't have a provision for having attorneys appointed in civil cases, so I wouldn't be able to do that, no.
And am I allowed to contest this? I don't even live in Nevada, so I don't understand what this. How do I?
Yeah, and there should be dates and information on there. It's not a case that's in front of me.
Right.
But all that information should be on there on what's going on. If you need to ask questions, there's a TPO office.
Okay.
Downstairs here before you get to the metal detector, left hand side, they'll be able to answer those questions.
And if her and I come to some type of agreement or whatever prior to all of this, is that?
Well, I'm hoping you're referring her and I to counsel.
Yes.
Because
yes.
If there's a TPO in place, I don't want you to violate the TPO. But yes, by all means, have conversations with counsel. It's always better for you guys to resolve it than to wonder what I'm going to do about it.
So other than this bogus TPO here, what law is keeping me from seeing my children right now.
There's no law keeping you from seeing your children right now. There's just no order in place because that request hasn't been made to me.
Okay. Do I do the request?
Mm-hmm. If that's what you want, yes.
Yeah, it's been 20 months since I've seen my children.
Then if you want to stop at the self-help center as well, which is right next to the, very close to the TPO office, you can ask
and
them.
That's in this building, sir?
Well, sort of. You're going to go out the atrium, out the front door, before you get to the metal detectors.
Okay.
No, I'm sorry, self-help center still is in this building.
Okay.
So first floor, self-help center.
All right.
They'll be able to help you out with those questions. The TPO office is the one I was talking about a minute ago. Other questions?
I think that's all.
Okay. Yeah, feel free to have a conversation, see if you guys can come up with a resolution.
Okay. I don't know, Ms. Kasten, I tried to call you 3 or 4 times yesterday.
I
know. Okay.
That's okay. See if we can get together and get something resolved. If not, then we've got those dates set.
Okay.
Okay? All right, good luck.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.